Angels Care Home Health, serving Hayes and the surrounding areas, is a Medicare-certified home health agency providing quality skilled nursing and restorative therapy services to patients in their homes.
They're polite. I mean, they just take the time for you.
Angels Care is there to help 24 hours a day, and all services are covered 100% by Medicare for patients who are eligible.
I like the Angels for what they've done for me.
Angels Care Home Health. We serve patients.
Eagle Community Television presents Community Connection with your host, Mike Cooper.
Hello and welcome again to Community Connection from Eagle Community Television. Thanks for watching, and thanks as always to the producer and editor of the series, Jeff Durall, and thanks as well to Brendan Cooley, who joins us today as well from the Eagle Television staff.
And before we begin, we need to say happy birthday to the old man.
Oh, the AARP
inductee. Yes, who woke up on Friday as an AARP inductee.
Wow, we should have some kind of a special recognition. Yes. Maybe yes. His own personalized cane, perhaps.
Yes, I think that would be ideal. Or maybe Miss Clairol for men.
I like that idea. Good.
Neither of you are funny.
Oh, but this is as good as it gets, so enjoy it.
Growing up is not for sissies.
That's right. President Mirta Martin joins us today, as you've perhaps already determined, on our Community Connection. Homecoming 2016.
Wasn't it wonderful?
What an event.
It was. 100 years of an alumni association doesn't come around, but every 100 years. And this year we did it well. And what was great about it was that so many alumni came back home. It was so neat to be able to find people who said, I haven't been here since I graduated. And that was 20 years ago, or that was 30 years ago. And I kept saying to them, well, welcome home, welcome home. And invariably everybody said, you know, I've been walking through campus and the smile on the people's faces. And the welcome home phrase has been pervasive throughout the campus. So I'm thrilled that our alumni got to come back home. I'm thrilled that they got to experience the energy that is Fort Hays State University. And I kept saying, make sure that you take lots of pictures, because if you come back next year, this place is already going to be different.
It will certainly change. Prior to homecoming now, we go back to early September, when the Center for Applied Technology and Sculpture will be the new home for industrial technology programs, engineering education, technology itself, and a sculpture art studio. Mm-hmm. That was a groundbreaking event. Talk about that a little bit.
Well, you know, it's that's part of our re-engineering of our campus. Davis Hall, who has been home to the Center for Applied Technology, cannot be renovated. It has structural problems. And most databases showcase that in the 21st century, the need for applied arts, for applied sciences, for applied technology, for the trades, it's going to take front and center in our economy and certainly in our careers. And so we are preparing this university, and we are building the 21st century university to be able to educate the 21st century student. And so that will be a focus for our campus. That will be a return to those arts and those sciences that are highly utilized and highly needed. And so, you know, the people there have called it CATS, mm-hmm. Center for Applied Technology and Sculpture. And so CATS will be a forefront for the entry to our campus, showing individuals, showing the world that we are forward thinking and world ready. And so we're very thankful that that's going up. You know, I left, as you know, for China, and it was just the bottom floor that was up. I came back 10 days later, and now the whole thing is up. So we're moving very quickly, and we plan to get in there with God's help sometime in late summer, so that we're ready to open the doors to the class of 2021. Mm. If you can imagine. I was talking the other day about the fact that today, all data suggests that by the year 2020, 69% of all jobs will require a two-year degree, and in Kansas it's even higher, 71%, and they're the individuals were kind of knocking their heads, and there was this thing, well, that's not all that, it's a little far. And I said, in case you haven't added up, 2020 is not 20 years from now. 2020 is the graduating class of our freshman class. And all of a sudden it was like, oh my, she's right. Mm-hmm. And so we're preparing to be able to meet the needs of our workforce and provide them with an educated workforce. Our placement rate is 95%. We're very proud of that, and we want to go ahead and continue to provide our students with meaningful careers so that they, when they graduate, they can go into those careers and achieve their dreams and achieve their goals. And we certainly want to continue to grow that number from 95 even to 100 so that we can say 100% of our students are placed within 6 months of employment.
We had a chance to talk with the CEO of the foundation at Fort Hays State, mm-hmm. Jason Wilby, about the rollout of the $100 million Journey campaign.
It was.
A five-year campaign, even the official coffee mug now.
Absolutely. It's, you know, when we rolled it out, I spoke about the fact that in times of trouble, we need to step up our game. And the Journey campaign is representative of the vitality and the valiant efforts of this community. The Journey campaign, the $100 million goal, is the largest, most aggressive capital campaign in the history of Fort Hays State University. But our students deserve it. Our students deserve to have access to that American dream that you and I have lived and are living. Our students deserve being able to graduate with little debt. Our students deserve being able to explore the world so that they're able to do business in a global marketplace. And whether it's 10 days or whether it's a semester or a year, the experience to go abroad and study abroad is transformational. It's quite different for you to study and how to do business with a foreign country when you actually are there and when you see the customs, when you see the people, when you appreciate the way that business is being conducted. It makes you stronger. It gives you a competitive value and a competitive advantage. And we want to give our students the competitive advantage that they deserve to do business in this global market, to do business in this global marketplace. Yes, they're from Kansas, and yes, they'll continue to do business in Kansas, but it's just not any longer going to be in Kansas. It's certainly going to be in Florida, and it's going to be in Oklahoma, but it's also going to be in Mexico, and it's going to be in Brazil, and it's going to be in China, and it's going to be in Thailand. And so we've got to open the world to these students, and those are the parts of the Journey campaign that are important, the scholarship part of the campaign, so that our students, who most of whom we educate are first-generation students, you know, they come from the fields of Kansas. They're hardworking students. When I travel through Kansas and through the United States and I meet with industry leaders, with alumni, the first thing that comes out of their mouth is, we don't have to worry about those Fort Hays kids. Mm. They know how to work. And indeed they do, because that's what they've done all their life. They've worked their family farms, and even now they come to school, they work full time, they take a full load, and often they go back home during the weekend to help bring in the crop, to help those families. And so we're very much committed at Fort Hays to continue to provide the second most affordable tuition in the United States, and the excellence of our programming needs to continue to grow.
We're now the third largest mm-hmm. university in Kansas. You want to know why that is, said President Martin in the address. Based on that value of believing in people and connectedness to people and diversifying how we reach people and teach and educate and produce young people to lead the world. That's not just a bunch of words put together. That's the mission mm-hmm. of President Martin.
It is.
Fort Hays State.
It is the mission, and adding to that is to look after the welfare of this new generation. We have been given a unique opportunity as educators to inspire, to provide hope, to instill passion, to provide knowledge in this next generation of leaders. Everybody says that there seems to be a void of leadership in this country. Well, I can tell you that at Fort Hays Day, we're doing everything to correct that wrong. Our students have the ability, have the intellect, have the capacity, the will, the persistence, the dedication to become the next leaders of our United States. They're already leaders in their own rights. And so we, this growth is doesn't just happen. This growth is methodical. This growth exemplifies the value and the power of relationships. That's our distinctiveness. The fact that when we look at a parent and we say to them, entrust them to us, they're going to be our child. They know that we mean it, and we do. I always say to the students, you know, first and foremost, I'm a mother, and then I'm a president. And as a mother, I want better for them. We all want better for our children, and I want better for them. And that's why, together with the faculty and the staff of Fort Hays State University, we're charting a path to create a better world for them through education.
You're talking about what makes us unique, distinctive, the concern for the welfare of our students. And that welfare means a good education, but it also means other values that the faculty, the staff, the president bring to the student body.
You know, as I said earlier, welfare of our students, welfare is really of my kids, because these kids are my kids. As a parent, you work hard. You take food out of your mouth to give it to your children. As a parent, you want your children to achieve more than you have achieved, and you sacrifice yourself to give them those opportunities. As a parent, you instill in your children values that you hope they will carry throughout their lives. It's those values that create the roots, and the deeper those roots, the stronger the trunk, the stronger the persistence, the resilience of our kids. And that's what we do here. They come to us with incredible values from their homes. That pioneer work ethic is alive and well in our millennials. People complain about millennials, not the millennials at Fort Hays State. They're a different cadre of kids. As I said earlier, they're resilient and they're good-hearted, they're hard workers, and they have a desire and a need to learn and to explore the world. And for us, for the faculty, for the staff, for the administrators, our job is to look at them and nurture that intellect, nurture that willingness to go to the next level, and then open the doors for them. Now, you know, we all got where we are because somebody believed in us. We all got where we did because somebody gave us a hand up. Somebody opened the door. Yes, we had to go through it. Yes, it was through sacrifice. Yes, you know, there were times that you thought, why in God's green earth am I doing this? But somebody believed in you. And our kids deserve that somebody believes in them. And when we do, and I do. And at Fort Hays State, we're going to do everything in our power, all of us, to ensure that our students reach the zenith that they wish for themselves and that we as parents aspire for them.
Fort Hays State President Mirta Martin, our community connection. Another trip to China when we return with President Martin on the community connection.
Thank you.
Angels Care Home Health, serving Hays and the surrounding areas, is a Medicare-certified home health agency providing quality skilled nursing and restorative therapy services to patients in their homes.
They're polite. I mean, they just take the time for you.
Angels Care is there to help 24 hours a day, and all services are covered 100% by Medicare for patients who are eligible.
I like the Angels for what they've done for me.
Angels Care Home Health. We serve patients.
Welcome back to our community connection in the offices of the president of Fort Hays State University, Dr. Mirta Martin, just back from China once again.
Yeah, it seems that every time you and I visit with each other, I'm either going to China or coming back from China. Well, you know, we were talking earlier about ensuring the welfare of our students. A part of that welfare is to be able to build those relationships with students that are across the ocean. Our students in China are as much a part of Fort Hays State as our students here on our campus or our students who take classes through the virtual college. And we need to solidify those relationships. We need to let them know that they matter. They need to let them know that they have a home campus in the United States. And so part of the effort to solidify and to create and build on those relationships is we've committed to going a minimum of twice a year. So not unlike here on Fort Hays State, where at the beginning of the academic year, we have a student convocation, we have a faculty convocation. So too in China, we started to have a faculty convocation and a student convocation. And then of course in May, we have commencement here on the campus, which by the way, this year we're gonna have three commencements. A good problem to have. I'm so proud of our kids that are finally graduated and of our faculty and our staff that are gently pushing them to go across that finish line.
Yeah.
And then, of course, we go back to China as well in May. But, you know, what was neat about this trip in China was we decided, again, to begin to create traditions in China, not unlike what we have here at Fort Hays.
Sure.
So what's one tradition that you think at Fort Hays that we do once a week?
Gosh.
Tiger Gold on Friday.
All right.
So we purchase about 6,500 Tiger Gold on Friday t-shirts. And we put a QR code on the back of the t-shirt.
Mm-hmm.
And we went to CS International University and then to Shenyang Normal University. And we created, through our student convocation, we opened the academic year, we welcomed them back home, and then we gave them a Tiger Gold on Friday t-shirt, and we said, okay guys, now you can join your brothers and sisters across the sea on the campus of Fort Hays State.
Wow.
By wearing Tiger Gold on Friday t-shirts. And it was an impressive view to look up and see, you know, 4,000 kids wearing our gold Tiger Gold on Friday t-shirts, and then on the other campus about 1,400 students. And so we're really, they were excited, we were excited, and of course, we're hoping that as they're walking through their campuses that have only about 30,000, 50,000 students, you know, they're small cities, that those other students will say, what is that tiger? And what are those gold collars? Oh, look, there's a QR code in the back. Let me go ahead and take a picture of it and see what it's all about and drive him home to Fort Hays State.
Bring one back to show us?
Actually, I do, but it's outside. I'll have to show you.
Okay. Jeff and Brandon would like to get a picture of
that. Yeah, we can go
point.
Ahead and take a picture so that people can go ahead and start taking your picture through your back.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Tiger Gold on Friday. Part
in
of
China.
That, though, those relationships are paying off in the numbers, aren't they?
They are. And that's an important point for Fort Hays State. You know, when I got here, we had had several years of declining enrollment in China, and we were able to, through the work of our faculty in China, who are unsung heroes, they do incredible work. They are Fort Hays faculty, and they leave the United States, they leave their families to educate our students across the world. But last year we went up about 47 students. This year we're up about a couple hundred. And this incoming class at our partner institution, CS International, is the largest incoming class in the history of the program. We're almost at 1,400 students. So we're very, very proud of the work that our faculty here on the campus are doing, because they design the curriculum that is taught by our faculty in China, but also of the faculty in China, of our GTAs in China, who are there at the front line educating these students, delivering our curriculum, ensuring the academic rigor of our programs. They are the ambassadors of Fort Hays State University, and it's to those faculty in China and across the world that we're very thankful, because they are part of ensuring that our way of life is maintained. Those tuition dollars come back to Kansas to educate Kansans, to educate the next generation of leaders, and to ensure that our tuition remains the second most affordable tuition in the United States.
And something to brag on for sure. Warn Deborah Perdue ahead of time, because part of homecoming was the 100th anniversary celebration of the Alumni Association.
Yes, it was.
And we're going to be talking to her about that. So warn her ahead of time, would you?
She said that her hair turned gray because we had so many activities. And it really is a tribute to her and to her staff who did this single-handedly. They turned the campus upside down with activities, with parties, with receptions, with class reunions. The party, the campus was alive. Mm. And when you think about the work that they did, but we also have to talk about another group of people who did a phenomenal job, and that's our staff. Can't tell you how often an alumni stopped me to say, the campus looks beautiful. Mm-hmm. It's planted, the vegetation, the flowers, we've never seen it like this. So for those staff members who, the grounds people, our construction people, our maintenance people, our custodial people, who keep our buildings, who keep our grounds beautiful, we are eternally grateful because people notice. People notice when there are flowers in the borders. People notice when the trees are greens, and people notice when the grass is cut. People notice when they drive up to Fort Hays through the front entrance, and they're welcomed not just with a plain sign, but at a sign that's surrounded by beautiful plants and beautiful flowers. And our staff does a phenomenal job, and our alumni certainly notice. So I want to make sure that we say thank you to those staff members who always work so very hard.
And you go into the buildings at Fort Hays State, they're immaculate.
They're
pristine. Well cared for. They're just beautiful to be a part of the university campus.
Well, I think, again, that's that pioneer work ethic. It's doing the right thing because it's the right thing to do. You know, working at Fort Hays, it's not a job. It's not a job for me, and it's not a job for the people here. It's what brought me to Fort Hays. Our staff and our faculty look at Fort Hays as their home, and they take pride in that home. They take pride in ensuring that our buildings are pristine, that whatever is broken is fixed. They treat the place where we work as their home. That's what makes us distinctive. This is home.
Sky is the publication by Delta Airlines from October 2016. And we happened to obtain a copy of that, which features, let me see if I can open this, to the first page, and then she'll point out others. Mm-mm. This was not a purchased ad.
No.
Delta Airlines highlighted Kansas, and specifically Fort Hays State.
Yeah. Well, it was actually, it's an initiative of the Department of Commerce and Secretary Antonio Suave, who is making sure that the United States understand that Kansas is the place to live, that Kansas is the place to do business, that Kansas is the place where the Midwestern values that made this country great are still alive and well. And so we are mounting a campaign from that Department of Commerce. Welcome home is that campaign. And so we want to open our home. We want to open Kansas to the world. We want to open Kansas to all of the states. We want to open Kansas to all of the countries and say, this is a pretty good place. This is a wonderful place to build a business, to have a family, to raise a family. This is the place where you can still find that workplace, those individuals who, like we just said, don't just work somewhere. Don't just look at the job as a job, but rather they look at where they live as a home, where they work as a home. They look at it as a career to make life better for others. And that's a message that we want to make sure that the world hears, that we're open for business in a place where the values are still what guide our actions.
And she really didn't want me to talk about this, but on page 72, right there, President Mirta Martin, PhD, Fort Hays State University, President.
The more local important roots. One is the other one.
Fort Hays State. I know. Favorite eats in Kansas, local roots, and travel advice. from
get
the
off
president.
The interstate and come to see us at 4
come
Day State.
To see us
that's
at 4
a travel
Day State.
Essay.
There you go. That's the essay from Delta, the Sky magazine. Okay, back to homecoming briefly here in our final couple of minutes. At the homecoming game, there was a young man from Lindenwood, our opponent for the game, Connor Harris, who set an NCAA record for tackles. And during the break in the game, the coach, Chris Brown, Fort Hays State coach, talked to the young man, congratulated him on the just received honor. And when the public address announcer made the announcement of that, the home fans were cheering and applauding.
You know, our coaches, our athletes, are not just professionals. They're good people. They carry with them a professionalism that's second to none. And what is most distinctive and most important about that action is that it wasn't for show. It came from the heart. And that's what Chris teaches our players. He becomes our football team's father. No different than Tony Hobson becomes the basketball team's father, or Mark, or so on and so forth. I mean, all of our
soccer and volleyball
and track and field and wrestling, you know, all of our coaches look at their students as their own family. And when they see another team succeed, they show the importance through modeling good behavior and good actions to our students of what is the right thing to say. And regardless of whether they're opponents or on our team, we need to celebrate excellence. And that's what we do at Fort Hays State. We teach our students to acknowledge excellence, to be courteous to others, to be respectful to others, to say good game. Sportsmanship for us are not just words, are things that we teach and we live day in and day out. Because as I often said, when our students graduate, if they are men and women of strong character, then we will have done our job. And I can tell you that we're doing our job very well.
And there was one other point that was made during homecoming game, which three and four people asked me about after the homecoming game. And that was when the injury occurred to the Fort Hays State player. They noticed that down on the sidelines, with, I believe it was Shaq Cooper that was injured, President Mirta Martin was there holding his hand while he was being treated. That wasn't just for show. As I said to the people who noticed that and mentioned that, that's who she is.
Oh, that's very kind. You know, they are my kids, and they hold a special place in my heart. And I understand disappointment. And I understand fear of not being able to proceed doing what you're called to do. And for Shaq, he wanted to get back in that game. And but, you know, he had done his job. He had gotten us ahead. And his welfare is paramount to us. No game is worth an injury of one of our students. And no game will ever be worth an injury of one of my kids. And I'm a mother first and a president later. And so we're going to protect our kids first, despite their own desires to go back. And yes, these kids think that they may, you know, that they can conquer the world, and they can. But there comes a point where we need to say, love you dearly, sit down, because you're not going back there, because we need to protect you.
And mother knows best.
That's right.
President Mirta Martin, Fort Hays State University, our community connection.
Thank you.
Angels Care Home Health, serving Hays and the surrounding areas, is a Medicare-certified home health agency providing quality skilled nursing and restorative therapy services to patients in their homes.
And the Angel Care nurse comes to see me once a week.
Angels Care is there to help 24 hours a day, and all services are covered 100% by Medicare for patients who are eligible.
Angels Care has helped to stay home.
Angels Care Home Health. We serve patients.